In this video, you're going to learn how to build an Angular grid with the Ignite UI CLI in about 2 minutes. Let's get started. I'm here at the Ignite UI for Angular samples page. I'll paste this URL into the notes, but this is where you would go to get started with the CLI. So you can see there's a topic, getting started with the CLI. It shows you how to install it, and it kind of walks you through the different options that you have. The way the CLI works is it's template driven. So we've created a bunch of different template styles that you can use to easily create a brand new Angular project or add Ignite UI features to your existing project. So for example, if we use the IG CLI, the Ignite UI CLI, I can do a new Angular project and I can automatically give it the template with the side nav schematic. Let's go ahead and see how this would work. So here I am in Visual Studio Code, and I'm going to type in IG. I've already done the npm install /g for global Ignite UI CLI. So let's give this a name. So we'll just call it customer app. And this is going to be an Angular application, Ignite UI for Angular. I'm going to do the default side navigation, and I'm going to use the default theme for this project. And I want to go ahead and add a component. So let's go ahead and add a grid. So I'll do a standard grid, and let's do a grid with summaries. And I'll just call this one summary grid. And I want to go ahead and add a scenario this time. So let's go ahead and add a fintech grid. And I'm going to call this one fintech grid one. And we will add another component. Let's do grids and lists again. Why don't we do a grid? We'll do a custom grid, and this will be custom grid one. And this is where you can go ahead and add any feature that you want. So using the up and down arrow and the space bar, I'm selecting items that I want inside my grid, like paging, sorting, grouping, pinning, etc. So it makes it really, really easy and really, really nice to do this. I'll hit the enter key. Let's hit complete and run. I haven't entered my email address, so I'm just gonna go ahead and use the trial activation, which is what you would get if you're not a customer. We're gonna go ahead and use the default port. It'll go ahead and install the Ignite UI for Angular packages, and this application should start right up. Now that everything installed and compiled, our application started right up. You can see this is the template that we used, which is the side nav. So we have the screens that we added, or the components that we added. We have a navigation menu. So this is the side navigation. These are all Ignite UI components. If I go to our summary grid that we added, which had several features, you can see that I have a grid with some data. I've got my column summaries. I have some other customizations like turning summaries on and off if I'd like to. So you can see as I do that, the grid summary area changes a little bit. I've got paging set on. Let's do 50 items per page. So I only have one page then, and I can scroll really nicely. If I go to the fintech grid, it's a little more advanced. So there's a bunch of rows here. It's about 1,000 different rows. If I select all, I can deselect all. You can see we have custom groupings enabled. So here, if I grab settlement, I can drag that up to the group by area. Now I'm grouping by settlement and category, so I can collapse and expand these groups. If I collapse all of them, I can see all the data here, expand all of them. Let's say I want to test out the grid's performance. I can push this all the way up to 10,000 rows, and you can see that everything scrolls really smooth and fast, just like you would expect, just like you would get with, let's say, for example, Microsoft Excel. The grid is virtualized horizontally and vertically. So if I move my right arrow, you can see there's probably about 60 columns in this grid. And if I move left, like so. So you really have no performance issues based on the amount of data. If I select some different rows here, let's click the chart. We can do automatic charting as well. And I can also flick up to the dark theme, which is really nice. So I've got a nice dark theme here, which has the green highlights with the dark background. And at the same time, you get the Excel style filter with this, which allows you to do things like column pinning, column hiding, sorting, moving right or left, and then advanced filtering. So you can, let's say, just give all the Africa and Asia Pacific records, and that's all I'm going to get in the grid. And in this example, you can actually do live updating. So if I just say live prices, you'll see now that the grid is updating, and you're getting right here about 10,000 records updating every half second. So about 2,000 different cells are being updated when this button is clicked. If I go to the custom grid over here, you can see, again, it has some nice data in it, some nice templated columns. And all of this is meant for you to learn how to use the grid. So if I control C here to terminate this batch job, if we open up the application that was created with the CLI, it was called Customer App. And now we're in Customer App. Let's open it up in Visual Studio Code. So we'll move this window over a bit, make it a little bit larger, and let's go to the source file app. Here's custom grid. We can look at its HTML, and what's happening here is the grid itself is the IGX grid, and then it is being bound to some data, and then you've got some property settings on the grid itself, and then some column definitions. Each one of those options that we picked in the CLI wizard end up being properties that you set on the grid. So sortable, filterable, editable. That's how easy it is to get this grid going. If we look at something more advanced, like the FinTech grid, you can see it has a ton of columns that were generated when we used that template. This is also showing you different things like how to use NG template within the grid itself. So you can see here's an IGX column with an NG template. So we're customizing it based on data that's coming in. So not only can you use the CLI to get going very quickly, you can also use it to learn the grid and how easy it is to customize, to bind data, etc. And if we look at something like our summary grid, it's the same thing. You have some different experience here in each column so you can learn how to use the grid. The nice thing about the grid as well, if you don't want to do any of this stuff, if I delete all of the columns here, and I'll delete the paginator too, and we'll go up to the grid, and I'm going to say auto-generate equals true, what this is going to do is it will automatically set the grid up and configure it based on the schema of the data coming in. I don't have to do any of that extra work. So you have options with the grid, but the CLI is designed to get you started very quickly and to help you learn the grid and explore its capabilities. To learn more about modern web products like Ignite UI for Angular, check out igniteui.com. Also, click subscribe so you can get notified when we post new videos on how to use all of our modern web products.